So I thought I'd grab some Matilda and head south to Bridgeport to Ed's Potsticker House. Whilst they are famous for those, they have a number of other pork items on the menu. So while I'm here, I thought I'd try and sample as many as possible. It's time for this goose to get fat. They really are trying to fatten me up here at Ed's Potsticker House, because as soon as I walk through the door, owner Ran has some of their famous pork dumplings waiting for me.
I don't often get the chance to sit down and eat before we even get in the kitchen, so...
Oh, really?
Thank you for that. But you guys are famous. Tell me about Ed's Potsticker House.
At the beginning, we only have a dim sum, dumplings and soup dumplings. That's why we name our restaurant is Potsticker House.
It's just soft outside, it's tender inside, and then it's fresh.
It's really perfect.
That's why we're famous in Chicago.
So you started off making the dumplings first. What you're famous for, what better way to start than to grab a dumpling? Pork in there is awesome. The texture of the pork, the flavor of the pork inside, and some other famous dumplings.
Actually, we call the Shanghai soup dumpling. It's a lot. But people love to hear that noise.
But this next level, that onion just offsets the pork, raises the flavor of it. This is just an appetizer though. We're cooking in the kitchen, right? What are we making?
Oh yeah.
What are we making today?
Today we're gonna make sweet and sour pork cutlet.
If it's anything like this, then we're all good.
But what isn't all good is the reception I get in the kitchen.
Say hi, chef. Hi. We're making sweet and spicy pork, right?
This is Chinese traditional pie.
Yeah, chef doesn't speak much English. It's basically gonna be like sitting down with any boss you've ever talked to. You just pretend you're listening.
Chef starts by battering the pork cutlets with potato starch.
Just another vegetable in the kitchen.
And then drops them in the hot oil.
Now we're gonna do the sauce.
Sauce.
Yeah? Understood that.
Well, if Chef isn't gonna let me help him make the tomato-based sauce, I might as well have a little fun.
I think I'm gonna do color commentary in the kitchen. Okay, Chef's moving around to the other side of the kitchen now. Grabbing what looks like to be fresh cilantro, and yep, it is. It was fresh cilantro, bang in there. You can see why this guy's 2-for-1 so far this season. Plated that up like a pro. We'll be right back after these messages, and we'll see you in the dining room.
We love a lot of dishes.
It's very authentic. I love everything.
It makes me think about my hometown.
Oh, thank you. After you, dig in. Uh-huh. Seriously. I don't know why I seem surprised. There's so much pork in there, though. Huge, crispy outside. And the sauce.
It's very gentle sauce.
Pigs need blankets, just something subtle. And that sauce is simple. Why you guys Chicago's best?
Ingredients, some of them we get them from China, so make them very authentic. Those are things reminds me my childhood.
Traditional, amazing dumplings, phenomenal pork dishes, BYOB.
Yeah, we are.
This goose is gonna stay here and get fat. Brittany, next time, it's on me.